4th class maths. Today I am going to explain as to line segments and polygons. Line segments and polygons in block 18. Children, I have already drawn here figures on figures. How are the pairs of lines the same? How are they different? I'll explain, children. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, one, first, second, third figure are intersecting lines. That fourth one is parallel line. How? Why these are intersecting lines, children? Intersecting lines means two or more lines. If you intersect, two line segment or line. Can take line. They're passing in a point. They are intersecting. This is called intersecting point. This type of, if a point is intersect, is called intersecting lines. Here, two, first one, line P, line Q, the intersecting point O. Second one, here they are not intersecting, but if we extend the line, they will intersect. This, see second one. See, after extend the line, this is here they are intersecting. Okay. Now third one. This is called perpendicular line. They are intersecting. It is called perpendicular line. So perpendicular lines means perpendicular lines are that intersect each other at right angle. See, like that. We can see this type of intersecting in right rectangle and square. Their corner intersect. Okay. See this here. Here it will form 90 degree. Okay. This type of intersect the line, you know, we call this is perpendicular line. Now fourth one, this type of two pairs of lines are called parallel lines. Parallel lines. Parallel lines will be never intersect. If you how much if you extend. Parallel lines are like this, no children. How much if you extend, they never intersect. This type of lines are called parallel lines. They maintain same distance. If you go extend how much, the distance will be same. Now what is intersecting lines? Intersecting lines. Intersecting lines, when two or more lines intersecting each other at the single point are called intersecting lines. Here two lines are intersecting a single point. This point is called intersecting lines or point of intersecting. Okay. Now this type of lines intersect like this. This type of intersecting lines are called what? Perpendicular line. What is perpendicular line? Perpendicular lines intersect to make corners which we see in squares and rectangles. What children? Perpendicular lines intersect to make corners which we see in squares and rectangles. See in square, it will be formed like this. Okay? They are intersecting here. In a rectangle, same. Okay. Next, parallel lines. What is parallel lines? Parallel lines will never intersect. How far we extend them? Okay. Parallel lines will never intersect. How far we extend them? Now coming to our topic is to line segments and polygons. Line segments means what, children? On our previous class I explained what is line segment. Line segment is having two end points. line. Now, what is polygons? What is polygons, children? I'll draw your fingers. This is circle. This is triangle. Rectangle. Okay? What is the difference between these figures? These two are different. This is different. These two are formed with a line segments. This is one line, two line, three line segments. Here, four line segments. So this is here more lines. Okay. Any closed figure formed with a lines figure, line segment, that type of figures are called polygon. Understood, children? Any closed figure formed with a line segments. This is closed figure, but it's formed with the line segments. Okay, this. Okay, this type of figures are called polygon. This is not polygon. Okay. What is polygon? Any closed figure formed with the line segment is called polygon. What? Any closed figure formed with the line segments is called polygons. For example, this two are polygons, children? No. These three are polygons. Why? These are closed figures formed with the line segments. Now, open your workbook, we'll do workbook sums.
Write date 29, 12, 20, 20. S2 line segments and polygons. First question, measure the line segments that make up the given polygons and name the polygons. So A bit, which shape, children? This is square. First write the name of the figure and you have to measure the line segments also. You know, children, in the square all sides are equal. So how will measure? These are the corners. Keep the zero. Start from zero. So zero here. 1.8 centimeter. So one side is 1.8 centimeter, all sides are 1.8 centimeter, because in square all sides are equal. B bit, C bit, you do it as homework. Okay, now second question, draw a polygon with 5 line segments and one side measuring 5 centimeter. See, once again I am reading the question. Draw a polygon with 5 line segments and one side measuring 5 centimeters. 5 line segments. A closed figure with a 5 line segments. Which figure, children? If you have 3, that is called triangle. If you have 4, square or rectangle. 5 line segments. What it will call? Pentagon. So pentagon you have to draw here, but what you have to do? Draw one side measuring 5 centimeter. One side should be 5 centimeter. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So mark. Right, 5 centimeter. Other sides, you can take any measurement. Okay, this is 5 line segments, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Third question, which 2D shape having same length of sides cannot be easily drawn on dot paper? Why? Children, dot paper will be like this. On this paper, which having the same length of sides cannot be easily we can drawn on dot paper. Why, children? So I'll explain you. A circle we cannot be drawn on dot paper because it is made up of points equidistant from one point the center. See, circle will be like this, no children? See, it will be equidistant from the center. This we cannot draw on dot paper. Okay, write in sentence, a circle because a circle cannot be drawn easily on dot paper because it is made of points equidistant from one point. Okay, next. 4th, draw two quadrilaterals beside square and rectangle that have parallel opposite sides. Label the sides. Children, once again I am reading. Draw two quadrilaterals. Here you have to draw two quadrilaterals that should be not square and rectangle. Okay. Now I'll explain, children. If a polygon is having three sides, that is called triangle. If you have four sides, that is called what? Quadrilateral. If you have five sides, that is called pentagon. So now you have to draw here. Now you have to draw here quadrilateral that should be opposite sides are parallel. Children, I am showing here. This figure is called rhombus. In this rhombus, this is not square, children, but it has four sides. Here opposite sides are parallel. If I extend this, it is parallel. These opposite sides also parallel. This is called what? Rhombus. This is trapezium. In trapezium, opposite sides are only opposite sides are parallel. Okay. These two figures you have to draw here. Okay. These two are four sides, but not square and rectangle. Okay. Now you have to label the sides also. A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, S. Children, I showed you now this rhombus and trapezium. You do it, draw it here. Do it as homework. I'm giving homework, children. I hope you understood. Complete your workbook. We'll meet in next class. Thank you.